Everyone that I know, including myself, has wanted to see a see-through diesel engine for a really long time. So after a lot of thought and planning, I figured I would give it a try. I've been putting together a method to make this happen for over 2 years. The only thing I was missing was a company that made a single cylinder diesel engine to start the first episode. That is until my friend Alex told me that Kohler makes diesel engines. I reached out to them and it turned out they were super nice people. And without their involvement in this series, this probably would have never happened. Simply because,
look at that,
it's already broken.
What?
The single cylinder diesels that I found were of poor build quality, and I highly doubt they'll be able to handle the amount of abuse that I'm planning and throwing at this engine. It's time to start this engine up for the first time, and for the very first start, I'm gonna pull start this one for the very first run. And after that, I'm gonna use the electric starter. So let's see how this goes. I haven't actually started one of these Kohler diesel engines before. Let's see what happens. All right, well, that was a lot easier than I thought it was gonna be. I mean, one pull, as you just saw, and the thing started right up. Now that I ran this engine for the first time, which was a lot easier than I thought it was gonna be, and you now know what engine I'm going to use to attempt to build the first see-through diesel engine, I'm gonna move on with the contents of this episode, get that dyno from the see-through engine bolted on this engine, dyno this thing on regular diesel fuel, get a nice baseline, and then I'm gonna try something I'm very curious about, which is the HydroDiesel. The dyno is completely installed. I've decided to dyno this engine on three different fuels. First is gonna be diesel, second is going to be biodiesel, and the third is going to be HydroDiesel, which I'm told burns a lot cleaner than the other two. Now that you know what fuels I'm going to be using, it's time for the first dyno run, which is gonna be on diesel fuel. I have my tachometer set up to measure the RPM, an exhaust gas temperature probe to measure the exhaust gas temperature, an intake air temperature sensor. That way we're gonna have a great comparison between diesel fuel as the baseline, biodiesel, and HydroDiesel. Apart from those sensors, the one thing I'm doing different this time is I'm using a thermal camera. So before the first dyno run, I'm gonna remove some of these heat shields to allow the thermal camera to see the side of the cylinder wall, as well as this exhaust manifold here. That's gonna give us a more accurate look at just overall how much heat the engine is producing with each fuel. I'm gonna do three dyno tests where I measure just pure horsepower and torque. I'm gonna load the engine till it gets to about 2800 RPM and leave it there for about 30 seconds to see how hot the engine runs on each individual fuel. To keep the results consistent, before every dyno run, I'm gonna start the engine and let it run for 5 minutes straight at full throttle. And then at the 5 minute mark, I'm gonna start the test. That was my 2800 RPM target run on diesel fuel. Let's take a look at those numbers. Okay, so that was the Dyno Run on diesel. Next, we're gonna do the Dyno Run on biodiesel. So that was the Dyno Run on biodiesel. Now I'm gonna put hydrodiesel in the tank, bleed the lines so it's 100% hydrodiesel, and then my Dyno Run on hydrodiesel. So that went pretty well overall. Hopefully I gave you some valuable information. This was quite a setup that we had to do here to measure what we measured here. And I thought it was a pretty good comparison. I know people are gonna ask for some more like solid results, but that was pretty good. That being said, I have another episode with this engine coming up next. And I'm not gonna tell anybody what it is, but it has something to do with this turbo right here. Tell me what you think it's gonna be in the comments below. And tell me what you thought about this video. Hopefully you enjoyed it. And let me know if you have any other test ideas that you wanna throw out there. One of the things I was gonna measure was the particulate coming out of the exhaust, but I skipped that just because we had a lot of stuff going on already. So that being said, thanks for watching. Tell me what you think in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe and see you next time. Oh man, what a mess. You definitely need a new container.